Hey, what's up everyone and welcome to Daily Code Buffer. In this video, we are going to see how to deploy Spring Boot application to AWS using Docker. So let's jump into it. So in the previous tutorial, we have created the application where we were pushing the Docker images to Docker Hub using Spring Boot and Maven, okay? So we'll be using the same project, same application over here, because our main goal is to push the application as a Docker image to Docker Hub or any of the registry and pull that image into an EC2 instance using Docker and run it. Okay. So you can see that in that previous application. If you haven't seen that video, I'll link into the description below. You can check that out. So that application was containing a main Spring Boot application file and one home controller. Okay. That home controller is having one default or root mapping to /, and it will return subscribe to Daily Code Buffer. So guys, do subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get notified of all the new videos. It helps a lot to me and keeps me motivated to create a new video. So this is the home controller. Okay, you can see that we have application.properties files, and in that we have added the port as 9091. Okay, so my application will be running on 9091. We also have a Docker file, okay? In this Docker file, what we are doing is we are using OpenJDK 11 and we are keeping our jar file from target directory to the Docker image, and we are giving the entry point as java-jar and the app name, okay? app.jar. So this way my command will run as java-jar and the app name when we run the Docker image. So in the previous tutorial we saw that we were pushing the image, okay? So let's push the image once again, okay? We'll run from the terminal. Okay, before that, let's change the version of our application. Okay, we'll change the version from 0.0.2 to 0.0.3. So we can get to know it's the latest version. Okay, now we'll do mvn clean package and we'll push this image using Dockerfile plugin. Dockerfile push. Okay. Okay, let it complete everything. Okay, meanwhile we'll go to our Docker Hub. Okay, we'll go to our Docker Hub. You can see that we have a repository, Daily Code Buffer, and in that we have a Docker publish image. Okay, you can see that we have 0.0.1 and 0.0.2 version. Okay, we should get 0.0.3 version once this is completed. Okay, now let's refresh it again. You can see that we got the newer version, 0.0.3. okay, so my Docker image has been published to Docker Hub. So now we need to provision an EC2 instance, and in that we need to install Docker and pull this Docker image and run that. So let's go to EC2 instance. We'll open AWS. Okay, let's go to EC2 and running instances. We don't have any running instances. Let's create a new instance. Okay, click on launch instance. Let me go to Virginia. Okay, go to EC2, running instances. Okay, and then we'll click on launch instance. Okay, you can see that we have a bunch of instances to select. We'll select AMI, and then we'll select the T2 micro, that is a free tier. You can configure the instance over here, or you can directly review and launch. We'll be doing review and launch. We have T2 micro instance. We'll be having a security group created, a storage created, okay? And then click on launch. Okay, this will be asking to select a key pair. Okay, if you don't have a key pair, you can create a new one over here, or if you have already, you can directly map and click on acknowledge and launch an instance over here. You can see that your instance is now launching. You can go to view instances and you can see that the status of your instance is in pending. So wait for a couple of seconds, okay? It will change to ready. So you can see that your instance is running now. Okay, so let's connect to this instance using SSH. Okay, click on the connect over here. This is the command to connect to this instance using SSH. If you are using Mac or Linux, SSH would be installed. Okay, so you can directly use this command to connect to. But if you are using Windows, you need to connect to via PuTTY. Okay, so I'll be connecting via PuTTY. So if you don't know how to connect to PuTTY, okay, you can follow the documentation over here. So that is a very easy step to connect to PuTTY. Okay, this is the one you can check. Okay, I'll be connecting it. Let me open PuTTY over here. Let me load one of the profiles and change the host name. Okay, and click on open. So it's asking for authorization. Click on yes. So now I have connected to my EC2 instance. Let me change it to root. Okay. Okay, now we need to update the system and we need to install Docker. Okay. So we will be running the command sudo yum update hyphen y. So it will update the system. Okay. You can see that it's updating the system and the update is completed. Now we need to install Docker. Okay. So the command is sudo yum install Docker. Okay. And it will ask for your permission. Enter y and hit enter. Okay. It will download Docker and it will install. Okay. Wait for a couple of seconds more. And you can see that it's been completed. Now we need to start the Docker service. Okay, to start the Docker service, the command is sudo service docker start. Just hit this service and you can see that the Docker is running. If you want to verify, you can just see Docker version. Okay, the Docker is installed and it's been running now. Now what we need to do is we need to pull the image which we uploaded in Docker Hub. Okay, so let's go to Docker Hub and you can see that this was the image. Okay, if you click on see all, okay, these are all the versions and you can get the command for that as well. Just copy that command. Okay, go to your instance and run that command. Docker pull daily code buffer, Docker publish, and the version is 0.0.3. And you can see that it's been downloading now. Okay, now let's talk about the port situation over here. So here you can see that we have defined port 9091 over here. So my application would be running on port 9091, but if you go to my instance over here, okay, in the security group, if you can see here, view inbound rules, it is only allowed port 22. So we need to allow port 9091, or we can allow any of the port and we can map that port to the host port. Okay, so let's do that first. What we'll do, we'll go to the security group, that is launch wizard 1. Okay, you can create a new security group and you can assign that new security group to the particular instance, or you can change the current security group which has been already assigned and you can modify that as well. Okay, so this is just a basic tutorial we are doing, so we'll just change the current security group. So we'll go to inbound rules, we'll edit the inbound rules and we'll add the rules. We'll add HTTP, okay, from anywhere, and we'll add HTTPS from anywhere. Okay, these two goes hand in hand, so I have added both the things, but I will be mapping to port 80 only. Okay, so my 9091 port will be mapped to port 80. Save the rules over here. Okay, you can see that the image has been downloaded. You can see with Docker images. Okay, you can see that Docker image has been downloaded. Now we need to run this image. Okay, so the command is docker run and we need to provide the port, okay, with hyphen p, and what will be the host port. So I want to map to 80 and my Docker image port would be 9091 because my application is running on 9091. That will be mapped to port 80. Let's give the name of that container. We'll give Spring Boot Docker. Okay, and which image we need to run. So I want to run this image. Okay, and hit enter. Okay, so what happened here is you just give the name of the image over here. Okay, so by default it will always check for the latest tag over here. Okay, so our tag is 0.0.3, so my version is 0.0.3, so I need to provide that particular tag over here. Okay, so I'll be providing 0.0.3 over here and it will check locally that image is available. Yes, image is available, and it will run that. So you can see that my application has been started. You can see that it started on port 9091 and now it's mapped to 80. So let's go to a browser, let's go to the instances. This is my instance and we can access this instance using public DNS or public IP. Okay, let's check with public DNS. Okay, you can see that our application is running. Subscribe to daily code buffer is coming. Okay, so this way we can deploy our Spring Boot application to EC2 instance using Docker. So that's it in this video. If you have any queries, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, smash that like button and we will see you in the next video.